Hi, I want to show you how to stream market data to Parquet. But of course, streaming is not enough. You want to analyze data in real time as you are ingesting it. And that's exactly what we do. We are QuestDB, a fast open source time series database designed for finance. By the way, we are the fastest growing time series database in the world. It's not just me speaking. DB Engine has been tracking popularity for hundreds of databases for years. And on the time series category, we are the only database that has been steadily growing for the past 3 years. And I believe one of the reasons for that is because we try and listen hard to our users. And our users were telling us, sure, it's pretty cool to be able to ingest several millions of records per second while running low latency queries. But if I need to reuse the data for something else, I don't know, powering machine learning workflows for forecasting, or just exporting the data to a data lake for compliance, if the data is locked in a proprietary format, it can be quite slow and expensive to export the data from the database, which is why we built a database engine with 3 tiers of storage. Tier number one is the write-ahead lock, which is designed for very fast ingestion. Tier number two is our columnar binary format, which is designed for low latency queries. Tier number three is the parquet format, which is an open data format designed for compatibility, and the data can be locally on your instance or in object storage in the cloud. For you to get the feel of how it is to work with QuestDB, I've recorded a short demo. In the demo, I'm going to be streaming SPX futures data, which is about 700 million records per day. The first step when you want to ingest data programmatically is to configure the connection string. Now you are connected to QuestDB, you can start sending the data you have on your data feed. In this case, I'm using the Python client, but we have clients in 7 different programming languages, and we have integrations with things like Kafka, Apache Flink, Spark, and so on. Once the data is streaming, you can power real-time dashboards like this one here. And as you can see, when I change the filters, the data refreshes pretty much immediately. But of course, you can use QuestDB not only for real-time, but also for historical analytics. Maybe you want to do backtesting or just checking what happened the day before. Again, when I change here the filters, you should see data refreshes pretty quickly, even if I'm querying several hours from the day before. I'm actually going to be querying a whole day of data, threading data right now, which is 700 million rows. And again, it is quite fast. But the most interesting bit for me is that if I go to the web console of QuestDB and I ask for the table partitions, I can see they are reported as being on Parquet, which means I can use any tool that speaks Parquet, and I can point that tool to the files that QuestDB is generating, and without having to query the database, I can work with the raw data. For example, here I have a Jupyter notebook and I have pandas. I'm going to be pointing pandas to one of my partitions. And here you can see the top of the file in which you have the SPX futures data I have on my table. I can use, of course, any other tool like Apache Arrow, which is in fashion now. I point Arrow to the same partition. I ask for the schema of my table. And sure enough, you can see here, I have all the columns, I have the metadata, I have the column types, and I can go directly with this. I could do, for example, something like asking Arrow to count how many rows I have, not on this partition, but on the whole data set. And as you can see, in this particular table, I have right now for this demo about 1.5 billion records, which is 2 days of data roughly. And then I could use Arrow for anything else. I can, for example, add a filter and count how many rows I have containing any of these two values. And all of this pointing directly to the Parquet file without having to query the database if I don't need it. So this is what I wanted to show you. If you like what you saw, we have a live demo at demoquestdb.io, or you can browse our repository at github.com/questdb. Thank you.